A stakeholders group told senators on Monday that farmers in La Trinidad and Benguet province have been losing an average of 2.5 million pesos a day since the start of the year because of agricultural smuggling. For more on their plight, we are joined by Agot Balanoy. She is a public relations officer of the League of Associations at the La Trinidad Vegetable Trading Areas. Good morning po, Ma'am Agot. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Ma'am Nikki, and to all the viewers.
Okay, so first off po, Benguet farmer is now losing 2.5 million a day after more struggled carrots entered the market this year. No, how much of a decline po is this from last year's numbers?
From 20 to 40% at the moment, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
So if we got the average of 30%, and then the monetary value of this 30% decline of purchase arrived to 2.5 million pesos per day.
And how is this impacting your farmers?
Well, during the past two years, the agricultural sector was hard hit with the pandemic effects. Now, this is another blow. So the farmers now are having four main problems, major problems. Number one would be the smuggling. Number two would be the increase of farm inputs, continuous increase of farm inputs, the low demand. But at least that one for now is improving a little. And of course, the fuel price increase. So those are the four major problems of the farmers. Now, during the pandemic, they have been experiencing low price of vegetables for how many seasons of croppings now? So the farmers are having are running out of capitalization. And with this smuggling, the farmers are actually throwing away one-fourth to one-half of their harvest because it is not meat. Especially the medium-sized carrots, they are not being bought, they are being given for reliefs only. But our problem is that the cost of production per kilo of carrots, for example, is 25 pesos per kilogram. So if a farmer would throw away at least 5 tons of his harvest, that would be too much for them to take.
And Ma'am Agot, why do you think less consumers are buying carrots from local vegetable growers, you know, preferring to buy the smuggled ones from China? Are these even proven safe to eat?
According to the buyers, they are, of course, businessmen. Now, they prefer the smuggled China carrots because the shelf life is longer. It can last for 2 months without being destroyed. But our carrots, just for 2 to 3 days, the carrots would start to rot. So the businessmen would rather have the China carrots because that would be lower in wastage, lower losses. But of course, the actual consumers who will eat the vegetables do not know that much. Most of the buyers that are buying from Divisoria are businessmen, restaurants, hotels, those. But of course, not much on the consumers. So the consumers doesn't actually know, according to the DTI or the central office who joined us yesterday on the Senate hearing. She said the consumers do not even know the difference of a smuggled China carrots compared to that of the Benguet carrots. So that's one of the good things that happened yesterday, the pushing of the educational information drive for the consumers so that they would be knowing what they are buying. And of course, branding for the vegetables coming from our local farms.
And Senate President Tito Soto has since noted that the Senate panel has heard of inconsistencies between the Department of Agriculture and the Bureau of Customs' agricultural import records. What are these? Do you agree that the automation of records-keeping systems will deter smugglers?
The only advantage of that would be keeping a real-time record, knowing the real-time record. But actually, for now, they can still do something about the smuggling. For me, that's just an excuse. It may make their work easier, considering that, according to them, they are undermanned Like for the Department of Agriculture, they lack personnel, they lack budget for that. So that one, the automation would just help them save time, to make them monitor on real time. But that should not be the excuse for not acting on this smuggling issue. As of the moment, there are a lot of China carrots that are being sold in the market today, in the north as far as Urdaneta market, and in the south we have seen them in Batangas, Iloilo, even Cebu. Those key markets are already flooded with China carrots.
And following this, when he was asked about how the Senate can curb smuggling, Soto also said that they can always make an appeal, but it is up to the executive department to decide on what to do next. So any update from the office of the president as of now?
There is no communication coming from, or no action that we have seen coming from the office of the president or the executive office. In fact, even our letter to the Bureau of Customs was never answered. We sent the letter last year, but it's still not answered up to now.
So has any government official reached out to you, even local government units?
In our local
perhaps
government,
offered to help, no?
Actually, this is the first time that we have experienced a long bout of smuggling issues. Previously, there are some smuggling issues, but it won't last a week. It's because our LGU here before would act on it immediately, reach out to the national level, and in partnership with the private stakeholders, and the problem on smuggling usually stops in less than a week. But this time it is already month. March is the ninth month that we are complaining about this to no avail. And the smugglers are really, they have become blunt. They unload at daytime. They distribute at daytime. They do not even care to cover all those boxes marked with fresh carrots, fresh China produce. So I think I would agree that the Department of Agriculture has admitted to us during our dialogue on March 19 that there is really a corruption within their agencies. That is one of the main reasons why they cannot stop smuggling.
And Mama Agot, we know we were open to smuggling mostly because of the decision to import produce. But how much of smuggling has taken a toll on the livelihoods of farmers and fisherfolk in the past up to this very day? And what's your appeal to the government on how to address this?
If we say the past, like previous administrations, we did not suffer that much from smuggling. But during this administration, I'm so sorry that as I've said earlier, we have felt, this is the first time we felt a long bout of smuggling problem. We appeal to the government that it's actually easy. I mean, the Bureau of Customs and the Department of Agriculture are saying that they need to do this, they need to do that. They can just go to the different cold storages. They can just go to the different markets and they will know. In fact, we have even given them an information about certain person. We have given the name, the address, and then the system of distribution for them to act on it. But up to now, they did not act on it. So we have given them the information. It's just a matter of doing or implementing things so that this distribution of smuggled carrots in Prosy market would stop. But they did not act on it up to this day. So to the government, we would like to ask for a more serious, I hope they take us seriously, because the farmers are really losing 2.5 million pesos a day. Their cost of production, as I've said, is 25 pesos per kilo, yet they do not get anything from their crops. That would end. They do not even provide for the capitalization of the farmer. So how will the farmer survive with that? We supply 60 to 70% of vegetables all over the country.
And Ma'am Agot, just for clarification, these smuggled produce, what countries are they usually from?
Actually, China.
China.
Those that are entering, illegally are actually coming from China. Broccoli, carrots, cauliflower, onion leeks, our ginger, garlic. Actually, our farmers also, rice farmers, onion farmers, the ginger farmers are also complaining about this one. Because as when we talk of volume, the volume of carrots, garlic, ginger, and onions, onion bulb is just the same. The smuggled ones that are flooding the markets.
And Ma'am Agot, lastly, so what then is your appeal to the general public naman? How can we perhaps help?
To the consumers, I hope you will also educate yourselves, trying to know the difference of the imported and the locally grown. Let's patronize the produce of our farmers, because that is their only source of living. And to the other farmers groups, I hope that are victimized with smuggling, I hope they reach out to us so that we can hold hands together and complain. Perhaps if the more number we have, perhaps the government would listen to us finally.
All right. On that note, we continue hoping for the best. No, thank you so much for joining us, Ma'am Agot. You stay safe po.
I'm sorry.
And you stay safe, Ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, thank you.